Good evening, streamers. I hope you guys are having fun. My topic is, yay, to dunk or not to dunk. Basically, who here loves a cup of tea? I'm sure everybody loves tea. People who love coffee love iced tea. People who love alcohol love green tea. But everybody loves some form of tea. And what is tea best enjoyed with? Biscuits or cookies or whichever mantra works for your thing. But the most important thing in life, and as well as with tea, is you have to combine it with the right element. You take a wrong cookie and put it with the wrong tea, and your day is completely ruined. Completely. So, moving on, I think this is the main hero of this presentation, Benedict Cumberbatch, which is a supporting actor. So, this is the hero of today's talk, which is how much pleasure can you get out of a dunked cookie? And you cannot just stop going for it. I think in life, in general, for everything, there's a lot to learn from this. So what we have been told is dunking is an art. You have to know when to stop. You have to know when to take it out. And I'm only talking about dunking here, no other activity. But that's important. And similarly, you have to know what goes with what. You can't have, so for example, Madeleines will go very beautifully with the green tea. Earl Grey is best enjoyed with shortbread. Similarly, do not take the brand managers to the analyst meet. Blow hot, blow cold. This is very interesting because you have to brew the tea right. So there's an 80-20 rule for green tea. At 80 degrees Celsius water, you have to brew the tea for 20 seconds, and that's when you get the best cup. You want to get a gift out of your husband after 10 years, you have to brew him. You have to brew him really right. Brew. Opposites don't attract. We've been forming a lot of we've been forming a lot of accessories with tea, but they have to gel, they have to match. And I will tell you, please try this at home. This is no big stunt, but the amount of fun that you can have, because every biscuit is different. Having worked in a global team and having members from across the globe, every biscuit is different. So rational humans would brew the tea first and add milk. There are only two types of people. Rational and people who voted for Trump. The WTF generation or that demographic does not know how to have tea. So they can basically have tea with anything. There's also a form of etiquette. So there are tea cafes in London, in Britain, where you will be asked to leave if they see you dunking a tea. But like I said, different strokes for different folks. You have to, in India, if you want a promotion, go dunking cookies with your boss. But there would be times when you shouldn't dunk, especially when I've spent 1 hour to make those cookies at home. Please don't go and ruin them in the tea. Especially when the queen comes, and queen can come, Meghan Markle is there, she can really come now. There are things that I learned from my journeys across the globe. Cookies is not the only thing that people dunk in tea. As you can see, the range is wide. So in Africa, banana and tea is the first thing they have every morning. And I think now the topic goes a little beyond to what is life. There is no physical, there is no metaphysical. The cookies become the tea has become the cookie. So what really is it that life is trying to teach us? And you know, actually, if there was no such thing as a perfect metaphor for tea, designers, graphic orienters across the globe would not have come up with such beautiful art. This is actually just 2 seconds of Google, but this really shows love. And I work for Tata Global Beverages, which is a global tea, coffee, water company. This is the basic plug-in I could have for tea in this room. So please, go soak it up.